You got the tickets?
So the parking situation is a little bit janky.
Janky.
They don't have enough parking for the Palms and like the Palms residents and guests and attendees of the show. So they told us to park at Bubba Gump and also or park at
Dollar Tree.
And then they got shuttles that they run back and forth. Now, granted, we could have called Patrick, our personal Uber driver, to pick us up. But
personal chauffeur.
It's not a long walk, so I think we'll live.
Yeah, we'll be fine. Come on, bud. You know, it's interesting. State trooper. There's never state troopers over here. It's always just the county, the city. But because of this, I've seen two state troopers so far.
And that SWAT team truck. Did you see it?
No.
You didn't?
No.
How did you miss it?
I don't know.
All right, you'll see it when we get up there.
Okay.
So this is the line that we've already sat through. Got our instruction not to park here. Maybe they should put up a sign or something.
That says
everybody's going to do the same thing.
Yeah.
So we got a Cadillac ATS. We got this GTR. Got Zebra.
Where do you want to cross?
Got a Mach 1. Is it Mach 1? Yeah.
What sucks is for the ones who aren't part of this that just want to get back to their room.
Oh, yeah. So we will cross.
Like what? Come on.
Let's cross,
side of me.
Let's cross behind the Mustang.
To you? Oh, Dad's camera. Don't walk through the puddle.
Yeah, they should have a sign.
Yeah, because there's no parking unless he's like in the show. Because
they should have a sign. And let
people
know.
I think we gotta cross over in front of him in a second. Maybe we can walk behind, I guess. Oh, the smell of exhaust.
Yeah. There's a SWAT team truck.
Oh, there it is.
If it was a snake, it would have bit
you. But look, what's great is he's telling the person who's staying here that there's no parking right now, so they'll have to park somewhere else or come back later.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So that's not going to do very well for the Google reviews for the Palms.
Not this day.
Uh-uh.
But, you know, Destin.
Come on, bud.
It's like when they have events here.
Cross.
I don't know if this is actual SWAT or what. It looks pretty cool.
Can we what? Maybe. We got to be careful. I can't have a conversation because he's got me on the mic.
When we have actual events here, it's like they throw everything to the wind. It's like, traffic's going to suck. There's nowhere to park, but it is what it is.
Yeah.
Like the whole boat thing at Destin Commons.
Mm-hmm.
Like they took away half the parking lot.
Yeah, so all the stores got screwed.
So this is that blue I-8 that we see riding around all the time.
Oh, yeah.
And honestly, this is where I found out about it. Because when I did the short on this car,
uh-huh,
it had the flyer in the windshield.
Oh, nice.
Otherwise, I probably would never know.
You see that?
Oh, I caught him before. Remember when we were over off Scenic 98?
And all the Porsches were going by and all the other cars?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember him because I like that color. That's my favorite.
Gentian blue?
Yeah.
I would guess. I'm not sure.
I don't know what it's called, but that's my favorite blue.
That could be a paint the sample.
Then you've got him. He was in front of us.
We got vendors here.
Oh, yeah, you do. Oh, that's nice. About killed myself. Oh, I'm skewed. I've seen that place. What?
You what?
What are you oohing?
You what?
She said ooh, so I guess you know somebody here.
No, you said you seen something where?
Oh, the I'm skewed place? It's over across from the Mezcal place. Why are they in the show? Oh, I guess we gotta stay in this line or you just walk by. Like, I don't know what's happening. We already have them, so I don't know what to do. Oh, okay. Come on. You gotta get in line to get stamped.
That's your new home. It just sounds like my class.
I was about to say the same thing. I tried to walk out here straight here right now, it'd be like poof,
so
like a little squirrel.
This was almost not gonna happen because of the weather, the forecast, the rain that was actually happening. It's almost like 30 minutes before it's supposed to start.
Yeah, it just cleared up and the sun said hi. It played peekaboo.
It just stopped and then you check the forecast and it's like, no, you're good till 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
Like it just opened up for this, it's 4:30 to 7.
Yes.
But we're gonna walk through.
Okay.
We're gonna take a look at some of these cars, we're gonna talk about them. Hopefully we don't get sick afterwards. There's a lot of cigarette smoke here. Even though it's outdoors, it kind of sucks.
Yeah.
But I will say, like, this is actually pretty cool setup. They got a DJ, they got speakers, they got wireless speakers, like, all around the parking deck. This is maybe, like, one of the better car shows that I've ever been to.
Better put together, orchestrated car shows,
In addition to the cars that are here.
Cars are really nice.
I mean, granted, it's an exotic car show.
Yeah.
So I guess the key is, let's see what cars aren't exotic.
Well, I've already seen a few.
Yeah.
Then I'm like, you paid to be in here, though. You know what I mean? Like, ma'am, you're fully clothed. Ma'am, you're almost naked.
I'm sitting in the middle.
Because that's where we stopped.
All right. So this is a 718 Spider. This is what I was telling
that
you
one,
about.
Yeah.
And you said you don't like Boxsters. But
I don't like Boxsters. This is different. Yes.
Completely different.
So I would take that one in that blue that I like or in chalk because that chalk over there is hot.
But this is the one that it's going to take you about 3 trips around the car to put the top up or down.
It's worth it. I need to get my steps in anyway. It's fine. I would get one of these. You want to ride around a convertible with me, kid?
Now, this car here is actually, I saw this one first at Starbucks. You came to meet me at Starbucks when the bridge was out.
Yeah.
This was with the blue i8.
Okay.
And I'm thinking, I'm sitting in the Starbucks, I'm trying to look around like, who drove this car?
Uh-huh.
It was a girl.
Nice.
It was a girl, but not only that, like, this is your cutie. Like, not only that, the sound.
Uh-huh.
Now, granted, we love a 981.
Yes.
We love a 981.
Yeah, we do love a 981.
But this is an S. But the sound, it's got a soul exhaust.
I was about to see the exhaust.
This thing sounds good. Okay. I don't know if you heard it when it left.
I didn't. So we need to keep soul exhaust in mind. I like the wheel she's got on there too.
Yeah.
But then I'm partial to the bronze gold wheels now that I have them on my Jeep.
It's a nice spec.
Yeah.
And you know, it's a manual too.
Oh, even better.
I'd almost want to go get another one, but the price that they are today compared to what we bought ours for, it's like we're paying extra for the same car we already had.
I'm always so weirdly proud when I see another girl driving manual. I'm like, you go, girl. Do it. Come on, buggy.
Now, how cool is it when you can just pull up your bone stock Macan GTS and stand out?
Because it's chalk and it's got the black accents. I mean, that'll do it every time.
Chalk,
all you need is chalk.
The good wheels. I would have went with the textured diamond plate
door,
blade.
Because the wheels are matted. But it's nice. I like the chalk color and the black. Not a fan of the red everything, but besides that, it's great.
Red seat belts, red stitching, Alcantara steering wheel. Beautiful. Got the roof rack. Pinch rails. If I had to buy a new Macan, I'd buy this one. If I had to buy a new Macan, I'd buy this one with a leather steering wheel. I can't do Alcantara.
So these two are just walking around recording each other. I'm feeling like they got into some sort of altercation, the girl with the pink phone and the guy in the blue shirt, because they were standing here having a conversation, filming each other while she like railed at him. And then they walked away and he started following them, recording them. And now they're doing it again. They're just standing there recording each other. And I don't know It's weird. I'm not quite sure what's happening there. I'll be keeping an eye because I'm curious. That's nice color, but I like the other blue better. I like Blurple, but I like that navy blue the most. There's a girl that we always see at the Commons.
Here's a struggle, trying to get your video and your shot in at the car show.
Yeah, good
Commons.
Luck.
What are you talking about?
The girl with the Subaru. She's next to the purple one.
I don't know if I would consider the Fiat version of the Miata.
I would not.
An exotic.
I would not personally.
Now.
That is the longest Ferrari I've ever seen.
That's a, which one is that one?
I don't know.
That's a FF. I think it's a FF.
It looks like it wants to be that BMW one, the shark one. It used to be called a shark, mixed with like a Porsche, like if they smushed together and had this weird baby. That's what that makes me think of.
You talking about the clown shoe?
Yes.
The M Roadster?
Yes.
The M Coupe?
Yes, that.
I think that's the FF.
And then the world's massive kidneys.
I'm not a super fan of the G80 too.
Yeah.
But look at these seats.
I don't like the kidneys on them anymore. I also don't like the seats.
I like them better in person.
Nah, it's too much for me. I would always clash with my seats.
Unfortunately,
my clothes would never match.
Unfortunately, it's a manual.
Unfortunately, okay. Well, because actually, the PDK, not this isn't PDK, this is...
No more DCT, so it would be a straight-up ZF automatic.
Ew.
However, you can't get a competition in a manual, so this means it's not a competition.
Oh, and that's what I had. I had a competition. My car was competition.
The F80 was a competition. Yours was an M Sport.
M Sport, you're right. It's hard for me to remember. There's so many different little subcategories on BMW and Porsche that I'm like, wait, which one is which? I left you. Hot spot.
I think these Supras, they can pull off a fitment really well. Just like stock. There's a.
I know, a gold new. I said the same thing. I said there's another Max, but red. A red Max. I like the Scion.
So this is a local. Because we see.
This is the one we've seen.
We see it all the time.
Yeah.
We see it in like a daily driving. Like they drive this car. I don't know if I would consider it an exotic, but it's
I wouldn't, but it's cool looking. But what's so weird is that we consider a BMW an exotic, but you don't consider an STI an exotic, because a BMW isn't either, in my opinion.
Well, I don't consider an M4 exotic.
Neither.
Or a Supra.
Now, what about a Scion the smart car?
How about an E46 Laguna Seca Blue?
I would say yes, because you don't see Laguna Seca Blue that often, and it's an older body style, so I would say yes on this one, because this one's more rare than that M4
extremely.
Over there.
Especially with the manual.
Especially with a manual. Yeah, I would say this one trumps the M4 over there. What was that Laguna Seca? What was the Mexico?
Well, you got Miami, you got Mexico, you got...
What was yours?
Laguna Seca.
Laguna Seca, but we thought the other one that we kept seeing was the Mexico.
Oh, and then you had... Yas Marina. Normal blue.
Yeah.
And then we would see a Mexico blue and a Miami blue or shark blue.
I like the Mexico because it was more green. And then you got the Toyota Celica over there. I'm pretty sure it's a wrapped Celica. Remember when I had the GTS?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So I guess this MR2 would be considered.
That would be considered an exotic, especially if it's right-hand drive, which it is. Look at the camber on that thing.
That's that VIP status.
Yeah. That's the drive it up here, drop it.
I mean, the 2
that
Series.
No,
two
that
series
one's on the ground.
Looking good.
Yeah. I don't like the mirror windshield. It makes me want to go watch cars.
Where are these cars from? Because we don't see any of these cars.
They're not from here. Look, I'm about to go around the back and see somebody's tag. Hold on. Let's go see where the M is from. It's from Florida, but I can't read the county. Did you hear the white one? No, was it him? Yeah, the white Cadillac down there revving, and but its exhaust was doing this thing, and it sounded like it was doing something wrong, but I think that's the sound they wanted it to make.
Yeah.
It sounded like a weird misfire.
Sponsored by Hot Wheels.
I would consider the S2000 an exotic at this point, because you can never find those anymore. That's interesting.
You got a Tonka truck?
I don't know about a Ford Tonka truck, but last time I checked, Ford wasn't an exotic, but do you, boo?
Got a GTS over here with some nice carbon ceramics. Look at those brakes. Jesus.
There's G-Wagon, but it's not that 4x4.
Square?
Square, that's what he called it, yeah.
This Aston is crazy wide.
Yeah, that thing is wide. Man.
Nice NSX.
I was about to say the same thing. But
That's a nice NSX. I like that color.
Yeah, the color's nice because it looks like it's like metallic, but not at the same time.
So I think this is the same Ferrari. I think this is the FF.
That's over there, I'm but this one sure doesn't have the front. Yeah, it's the same.
This was not my favorite.
No.
And I think that's a four-wheel drive, all-wheel drive Ferrari, I think. I remember when it came out, I didn't care two shits about it, so.
This one from the side, I immediately go ambiguously gay duo, and I want to go watch their little cartoon skits. Because it looks like their car.
Got some V10 R8s.
I do like the wrap on that one.
Got an e-tron.
Uh-huh.
I like,
you see Captain America?
They went all out on that wrap.
Oh, yeah. And then you got a Viper, but meh.
Oh yeah, who was telling me they wanted a Viper the other day? I think it was Brandon at Porsche.
I was about to say, who?
He wanted to sell the ZR1 and go get a Viper.
Why? I mean, why? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to make it like sound like that, but why?
Is this the paint or is this my sunglasses?
The paint. It's like an orange red. We see this one. I've seen Hulk Smash numerous times.
Got the Dodge Takeover crew. Black Betty.
I like that one. I've seen Hulk Smash rolling down 98.
Really?
Oh, there's Deadpool.
I've never seen this.
You've never seen Hulk? I have. There's Deadpool. I forgot we're recording. I told her, I said, I love you. She goes, love you. And I'm like, wow, the enthusiasm. I can feel the love tonight.
Got the old Chevelle?
Uh-huh. I'd take the old Chevelle out of all of them. I'm not even gonna lie. And then this made me think of that one car we should see rolling around Buford, you know, but this one doesn't look like it's on its last leg.
Oh, that one.
Yes, that one. Watch your boobies.
They went family friendly on the soundtrack.
There's a real estate agent.
Oh, those are the ones that are on TV?
I guess so, yeah. Yeah. They have a sign up in the comments. I saw them at Chipotle one day.
Eating?
Having a meeting with somebody.
Really?
Yeah.
I wouldn't recognize. Like, I don't know.
Only recognize them because of the full-fledged like makeup.
Like, I would have to have seen the sign.
I did. That's how I knew. But the full-fledged makeup and all the big hair. It's like Texas hair in Florida with all the makeup. It makes you go, it draws your attention. And then I was like, oh, wait, that's that billboard that I saw. That makes sense.
It's funny because like we come down here, you're thinking, oh, we're going to miss out.
But the car scene.
In Destin, like, you do have access to pretty much everything like you would everywhere else.
And even if it's not Destin, you go 30 minutes Panama City, you go 30 minutes Navarre, you go an hour Pensacola, you go an hour to Mobile, right? Or it's an hour and a half, maybe. But you have plenty of options to do and see everything you want that you would have seen in Atlanta.
We got the Cobra coming in.
Come here, bud.
Ladies and gentlemen. gentlemen, don't forget NASCAR's giveaway down at the donations tent. Down at the donations tent, there is a
cool
lot
car.
Of goodies for everyone here.
Oh, wait,
here.
He's on
don't
their
forget
line.
The People First voting also
he's
down
on their
at
line.
The donations
cool
tent.
Car.
Check that
it's a nice
out.
Car. I was just and thinking, it's going to be nerve-wracking, as I've done this show. Before, where you're trying to drive a manual around a group of people staring at you and back in.
Make it worse, no power steering.
Oh yeah, he had no power steering. You can see that on him, yeah.
It's too bad he's putting his hands all over the paint.
Yeah.
Trying to push the car.
I was thinking the same thing.
At least he doesn't have any rings on his fingers. Look at this joker right here.
Oh, so what's funny is I told the kid we're going
hang on,
to.
Hang on, let's have this conversation.
Okay.
Man. Got the R34.
Oh, I like the green.
We got the R34 in midnight purple.
Oh, there it is. So what's funny is I told the kid, I said, she goes, what are we doing this afternoon? I said, a car show. She goes, oh. And I was like, you know, Lamborghinis
this,
and stuff.
This car's probably $300-$400.
Are you serious?
Midnight purple,
I was about
R34.
To say, yeah. So I told her we're going to a car show, Lamborghinis and stuff. I said, well, an exotic car show. She goes, oh, you mean purple Lamborghinis. So that's the first thing I pointed out to her when we got up here was the purple Lamborghini. It was just funny.
If only Stradman was here with his new Gentani exhaust.
Yeah. Stradman. He's a guy on YouTube who has just a ton of cars. Yeah, if only Batman was here.
I'm like, how did you know what Batman had those cars?
Get a friend walk by and count on my hands. If I didn't know our friend Justin wasn't here, I thought that was him bent over leaning into the car because he looked like him. I was like, what are you doing? Now here's the problem.
Huh?
Here's the problem. Normally I would say those look exotic, but it looks very basic here compared to everything else.
I don't know if I would call a McLaren basic.
I know, but maybe it's the color or just the rounded front. I don't know. It doesn't stand out to me right now.
I like its subtleness.
I like it in blue, subtly.
Subtleness and
like
orange
subtle blue. Pain. No, that's true. Huh? Is it round green? No, me too. Did you like that? What? I said, look at this. See, here's the problem. You have to have these cars and also not give a shit about these cars at the exact same time to have this many kids and animals and people just walking around them, smoking while they lean into your car to look at the center console, getting really close to it, take pictures, because you just never know, especially with kids, if they're gonna know not to touch everything. You
dogs.
Know what I mean? Dogs.
You got a dog?
Yeah.
Climbing up on it, scratching?
Yeah.
You're absolutely right. But much like the Pagani Huayra we saw at SEMA, uh-huh. it had a PPF on it.
Watch out.
They didn't care. Yeah. No ropes around it or nothing.
Yeah.
The interior is a different story.
So they just spray the front of theirs? Because they're the only ones with water drops. So when they say, write down what number you want to vote for, what do you write? Since they angled it.
I like the color on that one. The old 348.
Uh-huh.
The only Ferrari you can buy probably for under 50 grand.
I would take that one over the 458 that we went and looked at.
If you drove it, you wouldn't take it.
Okay. I like the way it looks visually. What's so funny is I hate those things on the back of like the Challenger, the
louvers.
Yeah, I hate them. But this entire trunk and whatever, it's not the exact same thing, I understand, but it's the same design, but I like it over there.
Well, I tried to get a 355 from Pennsylvania, and he wanted $70,000,
$75,000
for it.
Uh-huh.
I just couldn't justify the annual or two-year $25,000 service.
Makes sense.
So we got, so there's a 355, but that's a convertible.
Uh-huh.
We went and test drove a black 355 hardtop in Atlanta.
In Atlanta.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, and then the red 458 was in North Carolina.
So we got a 360. We got a bunch of.
I like the yellow over there.
Gallardos. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh, yeah, I mean, the metallic rose gold wrap. That's nice. I hope that's a girl's.
So you got the first gen, you got the life cycle improvement. You can see the difference in the headlights.
Yeah. And in the little, well, that's his bumper, never mind.
Well, yeah, but then depending on whether or not you get a Superleggera or not, we'll change the bumper as well.
Hang it to the, see, that's the good color. Oh no, that's still. Yeah, that's the good color. Don't be afraid to hold that clutch. Ride
so
that clutch a little.
458.
Yep.
Spider. Interesting spec. Oh no no. This is a 488.
I was about to say, the right here looked different from a 458.
Yeah, it's a 488. Drive out tag.
I don't know the numbers, but I knew that looked different.
Well, I saw the wheels. I was like, no, those look like pista wheels.
From Tennessee, also. He came from Tennessee for this.
Those look like pista wheels.
He's here, U.S. Army. Nice.
This guy, we see him all the time. He was with the group with the
He's
blue.
He's an older gentleman.
992.
Yeah.
So here's a 458.
There you go, yeah. Could then have that fender dip.
Another 458, this is the one parked over at Kelly Plantation?
Yes. It has a dealer tag. Did you notice that?
Maybe they're a dealer.
Maybe.
White interior, carbon fiber steering wheel.
I like the combo.
720, is it 720?
I like the 720. That's what I wanted, was the McLaren 720 in that blue. I think that's the same one that Simeon Panda got. 720S. Is this what I sat in SEMA? I like, oh, the helmet.
I don't know if you got in one at SEMA.
Uh-huh, I sat in one at SEMA, which is why I knew I liked it.
I'm pretty sure.
I don't think we were supposed to sit in it, but I sat in the one at SEMA.
Simeon started off with a 570 and then he got a 720. 720.
He's got the blue 720.
And he's modded it too.
Yeah, he did.
So this is, we see
it. And now he's got a baby car seat in the back.
We see this one often.
I like that one a lot. Yeah, I like the bronze. I'm a bronze girl now. Who knew?
But there's another off-white Huracan here too, I think, with different wheels.
Yeah.
I think I saw it earlier.
They don't follow rules.
Thank you.
to count down the All Engine Round. We're about to count it down.
We haven't started yet. So that was just a taste of what's about to happen. Take shelter now. No, I'm just kidding. All right. All right. All right. Just hold on 1 minute. All right.
Where are they?
Until we tell you to. Yeah. They say warm up.
I know, they're excited.
So at 6 o'clock, they start hitting the gas.
Stop revving. I don't think it's gonna happen, but stop revving. All right, stop.
No, it's not happening.
All right.
I'm gonna win.
Okay, so we are gonna have the mayor do the countdown. The mayor of Destin is gonna do the countdown. And we're gonna have the real engine rev. After he does a countdown, it's gonna be 10, 9, and you go down, and then you're gonna rev the engines, all right? Everybody ready?
All right, well, thank everyone for coming to Destin, Florida. Isn't this awesome? This is a great event. All right, so the main event, we're gonna start it down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let me hear
Tiger in on Instagram.
That's what I'm on. It won't let me tag it.
You ready to roll?
6:30. The award ceremony will be right here. Remember, the donation tent with the raffle prizes is down below, second floor. It
looks like it's raining now, so that I want to get over to the second floor. The rain held out just for that. Spider got the top down. I don't think it's like a Jeep. You don't want that one getting wet. The worst part is if he's inside, he has no idea it's raining outside. I also probably don't really care. It's like Andrew Tate. He bought 10 Bugatti since he got out of jail.
Really?
He don't care. They were all Bugatti scooters, but he doesn't care. So the rain held out right until after the rev. Maybe Biden's on to something. Maybe all these emissions changing the climate caused the rain?
Possibly.
Nah, but it was pretty cool. You know, it kind of comes with the territory, but I think having the car show on an overcast day just made all the cars look even better. You guys know what I'm talking about. I don't know if it'll pick up on camera, but it is now pouring. It is pouring.
Okay, top is up.
And the Ferrari so got the top up.
It looks like, wait till the, is that an Audi?
Yeah, already.
Okay, yeah, he's in it. He's got the top up now.
Oh, okay.
I was worried.
I guess nobody's gonna sit and wait around to see who won.
Probably not.
They're gonna go bubble gum. They're going bubble gum, bubble gum, about to get packed. That's the end. This is how it ends. It was fun while it lasted. Hopefully we don't have any Mustang moments or any unfortunate meetups with telephone poles on the way out of here, but I think this is it. So now we got rev off part two. Everybody revving in the parking garage trying to get out. But that was cool. That was fun. Well worth the $5.
Since the mayor put it on, it's not like the police are going to yell at people for revving now. They can't. Watch out for this big old puddle.
The residents, the people.
No, it was not $5. It was $7.93 because we paid in advance. They said it's $7.93 in advance. Could be more. It'll be more at the door or it'll be sold out. So get your tickets while you can. So I paid $7.93. And then we get here and it's like $5. And I'm like, what the crap, man? Since when do you get ding for going for like purchasing first?
You had to pay that joker the transaction fee to run that card online.
I guess so. It was worth it.
Yeah, it was cool.
Yeah.
And
I enjoy seeing females driving the cars, manuals at that.
And then we learned the mayor Destin's a teenager.
He looks like he's 12. Seems like a swell fella.
We'll go left.
Go left.
Nah, you got that BDS.
Gotcha. Back. Big move.